Bey Fairy, and to celebrate Women and Girls in Science today, I'm going to show you some of the girls' beybladers. Well, technically they're not our bladers, but they're involved in the science behind beybladers. And I'm going to be starting with girls from the metal series, because I haven't seen the original, and I'm going to keep going through until I get to Beyblade Burst Rise, because that's as far as I have seen in Beyblade. So, to start off, we're going to do Madoka. Now, if you've watched Beyblade Metal, you know that... Did I spell her name wrong? I think I did. Madoka is the Bey trainer in the Metal Saga. And as you can see here in this wiki page, she owns the Beyblade shop, otherwise known as the Bey Pit, which I never noticed before. Never knew what her store is called. But basically, she is responsible for repairing all of the Beyblades when all the beads break them. Unfortunately, she doesn't battle very much. She only battles once that I know of. But she's a very important part of their team, because without them, they would break all the beads and not be able to battle any. So, and she starts out in the first metal series, first season or series, whatever it is called, and she continues on until Shogun's Spear, and then she's an adult. I've only seen a little bit of Shogun's Spear, but she's pretty cool. Let me show you some pictures of what she looks like. And there she is, there's some adults here. She's pretty pretty. I don't have anything else to say about her that I can think of, so I'm going to move on to the next girl, which is Maru. And Maru, I don't know that much about, because like I said, I've only seen a little bit of Shogun Steel, but she's sort of takes over where Madoka leaves off. Madoka, as an adult, doesn't do so much of the baiting for the new gen. She is a Beyblade mechanic and data collector. Trivia. This is interesting. Madoka and Maru playing together. That's so cool. I don't have much to say about her. I'm going to go straight to images. There she is, and there's this boy. He looks like he could be her brother, but I don't think he is. Who, as far as I know, and as far as everyone has told me, is not related to Shogun. Wouldn't it be interesting if Ren Kirinai was somehow related? two. Alright. Next door, I think, is... Nika is Vault Oi's little sister, and she and Toko, the twin brother, basically gather data on all the Beyblades, and they're able to analyze the weaknesses of the Beyblades. While they're watching after, I think it's pretty cool. And all three of the girls I've shown so far are really good at just on-the-spot data analysis. So cool. It's kind of reminiscent of Mario. I know I haven't caught that. Her Beyblade is King Tobias Knuckle Unite. Which is partially true. Because she doesn't have, again, she doesn't have a very profound impact on the story. She's sort of a side character, and side characters don't get their own days. Like their own unique phase, they get recolors of old phase. So, unfortunately, they never made her a main character. None of the Beyblade birth girls ever actually came to me. Sadly. So, yeah. She has that phase. But it's a weak color of Ken's today. If you can see it in action, in one of the episodes of the first season. So I think it's I didn't show you I didn't show you the picture. Oh, I had a nice one. So she is a sort of an older kid, like 11, 12. This kid is a little kid. Next, I'm gonna do Christina. Christina Carota. There she is. This is what she looks like in evolution with her stripy shirt right here. So, yeah. And kind of fan art on her. And then she has this blue and pink and black dress in, Turbo. Here's what she looks like. Alright, you get the basic idea. Christina Carota is not a base trainer exactly. She owns the base club, BC Club. And again, she actually does not battle that I have seen. Lydia's good, so makes her battle. And Nika. I have seen it to Nika battle. It's not likely, but it's really cool. And most everyone calls her Chris, but her full name is Christina Carota. I even say her birthday, April 22nd. cool. He does though, because he handles the Bey Club, he handles the selection of all the flavors. He has to research all the bays and their performances later. So he's also involved in the science of the beyblade the same way as all these other girls so far. And the last girl I've got on my list is Nari. And unfortunately, like all the others, she does not actually battle. Very sad. But she helps her brother either. So what do I have to say about Naru? He's rather close. Naru wants to, Naru wants to. That's a funny joke. So I thought that her birthday was on St. Patrick's Day. I was like, what, 17? Isn't that St. Patrick's Day? Yeah. That's cool. I think it's pretty cool to have a birthday on a holiday. Let's see. Unfortunately, he doesn't play a large role in the series, but he does go away on the ship. Oh, you know what I'm talking about. The battle. The battle bay ship. The bay battle ship. Yeah. Me and a couple of the other kids stowed away on the ship, and so she got to be part of the entire crew, the Bey crew. There's Mika and Naru. If I type in Beyblade girl, so I'll get more girl friends. Oh, I know what I should show you. I should show you Beyoon. Beyoon is the AI of the battleship. This is Beyoon. And he's pretty awesome, I think. He basically is like the announcer. They only have one photo of him. He's known as Bey Fairy in Japan. Cool. They don't seem to have too much about it, but a cool photo. It's got Beyoon here in the middle with Gunika and Christina Kuroda cut off, and what's her name? The cook from BC Lucky Soul. I don't remember her name. But I guess it's pretty cool that this photo has, like, the only time you'll ever see a girl-dominated photo of Beyblade. That bolt seems as far as I can go. I think it'd be really awesome if there were girl bladers in the competition. And they stopped us. I guess I was wrong. I guess Sasha does compete, but her bay isn't, she doesn't go very far. Competes for once or twice in the league, and I don't think they made a bay of, like, of in real life. You can't go and buy Shopper's bay, which is really a shame. I'll tell you Shopper real quick. So these are as many of the girls as I could think of that are involved in the science of beyblades. And I just wanted to highlight them and celebrate them for Girls in Science Day. And I have nothing else I can think of to say, so thanks for watching.